What's going on, everybody? It's Joey Atanzio. Today, I'm going to be going over how to load third-party patches onto your Line 6 Helix, HX Stomp, HX FX, and Pod Go. So let's get right into it. All right, so I got my website pulled up. So we're going to go from point A to point B to point C. So we're going to download a patch first. So let's say I want the John Mayer patch for the Helix and for the Pod Go. Let's go back. I want both of these. Okay, so I want to view my cart. And let's say, oh man, I want these for free. Perks of being the admin for your own website. You can just make whatever coupons you want. So we're at the checkout, so I'm going to place the order. Place order. And so then what's going to happen if it doesn't already, I have my download links, or it'll email them to you. So what I'll do is I'll download from here, click download. I get both patches on my computer. So then what the second step is you're going to do, if you don't have already, you are going to go to the Line 6 software page. And I'll link that link down below. So then what you're going to do is you're going to find your operating system. So I have a Mac. So then you're going to go to software, and the software you're looking for, if you have a Line 6 Helix, HXFX, or HX Stomp, is HX Edit. So we're going to do that first, and then what you're going to do for, if you have a Pod Go, you're going to look for Pod Go Edit. So then let's say we're using HX Edit for now. You're going to click go, and then you're going to find, you're going to have to scroll down and then get download. So I already have that on my computer. And then you just follow through the steps to get that installed on your operating system, whether you have Mac or Windows. So I'm going to open up HX Edit first. And they really function the same way, but I'm going to go through both of them. So I've got my Helix plugged in through USB straight into my Mac. And this is what shows up. So the first thing you're going to do is go find that patch that you just downloaded. So I have it on my desktop. And make sure you open the zip folder first before you try importing. Otherwise, you're going to have issues. So I'm going to open up, double click, and just open up my folder. And now it is on my desktop. And this is your Helix file. So then what you do is you go into your HX Edit. Open a new preset, click import, and then you're going to find that specific file, not the zip file, the Helix file. You're going to highlight it and open it. And then it'll say, do you want to overwrite? Hit yes. And then it'll be importing, and boom, there is your patch. So then you should have all of the snapshots involved, and you'll be able to click through. And so I'm going to show you how to load a patch onto your Pod Go. All right, so now I have my Pod Go plugged in, and I'm going to do that same thing, the exact same thing pretty much. It's just a different software that I had on the Helix. So I'm going to double click on my Pod Go, and then it's going to actually open up. So I have, for the John Mayer patch for the Pod Go, it's two patches because I want to be able to include all of the presets that I was able to use on the Helix. Obviously, you know that the Pod Go doesn't allow for as much DSP as the Helix. So I included two patches, just they're just slightly different, same amp, whatever, but different effects slotted in there. So we're gonna actually import two patches. So what we're gonna do is, assuming that you already have the software downloaded, we're gonna open up Pod Go Edit. There it is. So it looks a little bit different, but it functions the same way. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click, open a new preset, right click, and import. And then I'm going to go find that file on my desktop, and it's within this folder. And what I can do is I can highlight both of them and hit open. And then it'll say the same thing. Do you want to overwrite? Yes. Importing. All right, boom. So there are the two patches, and now they are on your device. Well, thank you so much for watching this video. If this video helped you, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. That'll notify me that I'm actually helping people through this content. If you have any questions, feel free to use the comment section below and ask those away. I want to use that as a forum to where I can help you with your line six questions, or maybe somebody else watching this video can comment as well and help you in the process. So thank you for watching this video, and we'll see you in the next one.